see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you.
Dear Bob and Darlene, I want you to know that you have changed my life since I was introduced to the VHP mission by my late friend, Dr. Brian Miller, in 1998. Thank you for welcoming me in the VHP family and inspiring me with your leadership, compassion, and service to others. Thinking of you in this end of a challenging year for everyone, loving hug, Christine.
Hi, darling and Bob. I wanted to take this time to tell you how much VHP has impacted my life. Being a volunteer and a family member of this wonderful community has brought so much joy, not only into my heart, but the hearts of others. It's been wonderful to see how many people have volunteered for over the years, how many patients we have taken care of. I felt it's been a blessing and an honor to be part of this journey, and I'm humbled. And to both of you, I wish you lots of love and blessings.
My name is Elisa Kuchma. I am Dr. Ned Bedrosian's daughter, and that is how I met Dr. Della Rocca. Dr. Della Rocca and Darlene are some of the most kind, interesting, sweetest people I have ever met. I had the opportunity to work with them during a volunteer mission trip in the Dominican Republic with a group called ILAC. Dr. Della Rocca showed us around the property, introduced us to everyone, and of course made us feel extremely welcomed and appreciated. His positive energy made me feel excited about helping others. He is one of those extremely rare souls that is filled with goodwill, kindness, and honesty. This mission trip changed my life as he and Darlene taught me what true selflessness is really about. He is in my thoughts and prayers, and I hope to see him in recovery.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see.
Hi, Dr. Della Rocca, Saya here. You know, there's so many amazing things that I can say about you, and I'm going to keep it short because I'm sure there's many people that have other things to say. But some of my favorite, most positive memories about my time at St. Luke's and having you as my teacher and one of my mentors is that you just always taught me to not just treat the problem, but to treat the patient. And I remember, you know, when you would deal with patients and how you would interact with them and the level of empathy that you had for patients that always really stuck with me. And I continue to carry that into my practice today. I remember when I was a third year resident, like 10 years ago now, that I was going through a separation and divorce at the time, and you really came in to check on me pretty much every Monday and Wednesday that you were in the clinic. You would come into my room, ask me how I was doing, and it wasn't like, you know, how are you doing with patients? It was really just, how are you doing with life? And that was, not many teachers do that, and I think that I really, really appreciated that, and I'm just so grateful. I'm so grateful that I was able to have you as a teacher, not just of ophthalmology, but of life. I'm so grateful, and I'm so happy that life brought me back to St. Luke's as an attending physician, and just like the conversations that we had at clinic, after clinic, before clinic, it was so great to be back, come full circle, spend time in New York as an attending, and thank you for encouraging me to do telemedicine when no one was doing it 5 years ago, just putting a lot of my efforts, and just teaching me how to be a good person. Of course, you taught me how to be a good doctor, but just always teaching me, by example, because you're such a great person, and you're so giving and so kind, and that always just is so evident to anyone who needs you. And I'm so grateful to have you as a teacher in my life. And thank you for coming to my wedding reception 2 years ago. I know it was a little bit of a hike, so I really appreciate that. I'm so glad that we get to hang out with each other.
Hi, Dr. De La Rocca. This is Ruthika Bakru. I graduated from St. Luke's Roosevelt in 2012. I've been thinking about you a lot in the last couple days. I just wanted to say thank you. Thanks for everything that you've taught us. You taught us so much more than just about oculoplastics. You taught me how to be a good person for a patient. You taught us how to care for the patient as a whole and not just as a case of thyroid eye disease or a bone fracture. I think the most important thing was is you taught us that being a good doctor was about being a real human, about treating people the way you wanted to be treated or the way you would want your family members treated. You always went the extra mile to help us or to stop and talk to us about how we were doing and how our families were doing. And I think that you just really inspired me to be like you and to want to try to, you know, go that extra mile when I spoke with my colleagues and my staff. Really, I don't think I can ever thank you enough for all that you and Dr. Marriage have done for us. It was such a pleasure to work with you and to have you as our mentor. I miss you guys a lot, and I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for us.
Darlene and Bob, I can't thank you enough for the privilege of allowing me to participate in VHP in one capacity or another for over 20 years. In the early days, I was a bicyclist challenged by the steep hills of northern Westchester. When you move the ride to the friendly and flatter course through Pelham and the Bronx, I was able to share the ride with Kevin and our children. For over a decade, you've graciously granted me the amazing experience of participating in the mission itself. With no medical skills and zero fluency in Spanish, you found a rewarding spot for me on the trips to the DR. Thank you so much for bringing me along on your amazing journey. I cherished the experience of supporting you and all of the wonderful medical professionals who volunteered their time and talents. Your mission provides a much-needed service to an underserved community. The mission has had a tremendous impact on my life, my family's life, and on all those you have touched along the way. You have made me a better human being. We love you and are thinking of you every day. Thank you.
Hi, Bob. Hi, Darlene. I know it's been many years since we've seen each other and talked to each other, but I just wanted to let you know you're in my thoughts. I wanted to wish you both a happy and beautiful start to the year. Bob, you have always been a father figure to me. The opportunities you've given me on these trips to Dominican Republic through VHP have been nothing but amazing. Darlene, you're like a mother to me as well in terms of how you took care of me when I was sick on my last trip many years ago. You guys really are a very special group of human beings that I'm so fortunate to have been known to work with, so fortunate to have gotten to know you both. The things that you provided, the program that you've set up, this organization, is tremendous. And you've affected hundreds of lives for so many years in such positive ways. And I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. The memories that I have with you and what you set up through the Dominican Republic trip through VHP are memories that I will take with me forever. And I owe you everything for that. So thank you for everything you've done to us. Bob, nothing but love for you and prayers. And thank you for inviting me and being part of this program. And it was an honor. Thank you.
Bob and Darlene, it's fitting that I should be standing in front of a Christmas tree because you have given me such an amazing gift that I could never thank you enough for, and that is the opportunity to serve others in such a beautiful way that you have shown us all how to do. And for the last 11 years, the chance to get off that plane in Santiago and arrive at ILAC with all the doctors and nurses and just the team, and to give of myself and watch everybody giving of themselves has just been an incredible, incredible experience and gift. And to be able to help those people like you've all helped us to do is just amazing. So I love you both. Thank you for everything.
Hi, Bob and Darlene. I'm sending this for a Happy New Year, and because I think it's important that you both know how much you are loved and how much we miss you. And I'm really going to miss not seeing you this year. And they asked if we'd do a video and send it to you, and I'm sorry for the delay. But as I was thinking about this video, it struck me in so many ways how your lives have been based on scripture. And the ones that come to mind for me, for example, is in 7th chapter of Matthew 24, it says, "Do not build your house on sand, but build it on rock." And I look at the two of you, and you have built your house on rock, the rock of salvation. And your family, your profession, your marriage, everything you have built is part of the rock of Christ. And it is inspiring. And another scripture I thought about with a chuckle is Ruth. In the first chapter of Ruth, it says, "Whither thou goest, I will go. Where thou dwellest, I will dwell." And thinking about that and all of the travels, Nebraska, New York City, upstate, and Connecticut, not to mention what the visiting and travel that the Army did for you, keeping your suitcases on roller skates. You were always together and such a blessing, and so committed. And hold on, I have a visitor here. Amos wants to be part of this. And probably most important is Jeremiah 29:11-13, where God says, "What I have planned for you is far greater than anything you can imagine." And your lives are a testament to that scripture. In establishing the volunteer health program, the thousands and thousands of lives that you have not only touched but changed, and mine being one of them. And I'm so grateful to you both for letting me come on that first mission. And I remember saying to Darlene and Julie on the last day, "You've got me till I'm in an electric wheelchair." And Julie said, "We can arrange that wheelchair accommodation." And to allow my students, those 6 or 7 years that I brought students to the mission, they still, I'm in contact with many of them, and they still talk about the inspiration that they had by going on the mission and providing care to the poorest of the poor. And how could you ever know just how dynamic and how fulfilling and how powerful that one decision that you made so many years ago to serve the poor has escalated and exploded into the blessing that the volunteer health program is. I know I will be part of it forever, forever. As long as I can move, I will be part of it. And that's because of you two being the great blessing that you are. Please know that you are loved and have affection of all of us. And I will be there next year for the mission. And just make sure we shift into overdrive so that we can all be together again. God bless you both, and thank you for everything. Bye now.
I was invited by Bob Della Rocca to his house to offer some suggestions and advice on how to set up the eyeglasses dispensing component of a project he was working on. I may as well have arrived with my plane ticket in hand. Little did I know I was already the volunteer health program optician. I was invited to his house not in an advisory role, but to meet my fellow participants. Honduras was the beginning of the VHP mission and the pinnacle for me. The scarcity of supplies made ingenuity a welcome blessing. It was apocalyptic at times, but often so simple and sweet. We all finished the day with a communal bus trip to eat together and tell stories. It was this fellowship that was the glue which gave life to VHP. Bob and Darlene have created a lifelong brotherhood sisterhood to those of us who've had the good fortune to experience VHP. A little boy with an intricate emergency, life-threatening head tumor was operated on by Bob, who saved his life. I remember Bob, with a smile, telling us the boy didn't communicate fully in words, but his facial communication told it all. He had a little tough guy expression and was pissed off at Bob. Every time Bob came around him, the boy would give him a dirty look. I think Bob admired the boy's strength and courage and appropriate response, and realized he would be pissed off too. Bob's renowned skills as a surgeon, his compassion, and genuine care for others made this boy's recovery possible. Bob introduced me to what I refer to as the motorcycle riders of ophthalmology, a gang Bob belongs to. Fists full of gauze, repurposing skin and bone, and the welcomed smell of cauterization in the air. That's how they roll. I always enjoyed Bob's artful way of engaging with a subtle infusion of humor. He would come over to us individually or as a group, and you would see his playful grin before he would ask a question or make a comment. You knew a witty exchange was coming. I value my time spent with Bob and Darlene in the Dominican Republic Church courtyard, engaged in conversation, enjoying the beautiful day and welcomed rest. The church created a humble appreciation of what our mission represented. I always enjoyed my interactions with Darlene. She always made me feel comforted by her delicate, graceful demeanor. I always felt a warmth in her presence, which confirmed the importance of my involvement and motivated me to stay engaged. I admire the way she works so intensely on all aspects of VHP, from the logistics to fitting prosthetics. Remarkable. Throughout the years, I've come to respect and admire Bob and Darlene and appreciate what they have contributed to my life and memories. Bob and Darlene, during these difficult times, know you are loved in my prayers, and I am forever grateful. Douglas. Of life is good.